Here's a question to Christians around the world. Do you really support Israel's war against its neighbors like Gaza Strip, Palestinians and others? I'm kind of surprised to see Christians supporting Israel, quoting Bible prophecies with picked up Bible verses and incidents that happened during Old Testament times, misquoting them, applying to present day Israel. Did you know there are several Bible verses mentioning Israel metaphorically, addressing Christians in general and not today's Israel? The fact is, there are a lot of Bible prophecies already fulfilled and some yet to be fulfilled too before Christ's second coming, the date of which is unknown, and the Bible says in Matthew 24:36, concerning that day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, not the Son, but the Father only. So don't listen to today's so-called prophets assuming the day. For several centuries, false prophets are foretelling by misquoting Bible verses. Even 1,000 years mentioned in the Bible is figurative. Let me explain now about Israel's war and the Bible prophecies and whether Christians today must support wars. Did you know Bible-believing Christians in today's Israel are in negligible percentage? Did you know there are Bible-believing Christians in Gaza Strip and Palestine, Lebanon and Syria too, apart from Israel? During every Israel war, innocent children and civilian people, including Christian believers, are being killed in all these countries. Let's examine this biblically now. Some Christians support genocide by Israel, quoting Bible verses like Deuteronomy 20:16-18, where Moses gives these instructions. God is giving you as an inheritance. You must not let anything that breathes remain alive. You shall annihilate them, just as the Lord your God has commanded. And verses like Amos 1:6-8 that says, the people of Gaza have sinned again and again, and for this I will certainly punish them. Friends, please know this fact. Most of the Old Testament laws were meant for the nation of Israel at that point of time only, and are not applicable to us Christians now. While studying the scripture before interpreting a verse, we must give due consideration to the context, cultural habits, historical and social background during biblical times, applying common sense using our knowledge of language and grammar, and also understanding the poetic, figurative and metaphorical statements in the scripture. Never take certain verses literally. Let me explain. The civil and ceremonial Old Testament laws like animal sacrifice, etc., were given to the nation of Israel at that point of time only to obey and please God. Some of the laws were intended to make the Israelites distinct from other nations, like the food and clothing rules, tattoos, etc. Leviticus 19:19-27 commands us not to eat anything made through grafting and not to wear clothes made of two kinds of threads. We know the vegetables and fruits manufactured these days are through the horticulture technique of grafting, and the dress we are wearing right now have different kinds of materials in the threads. Have you opted to disobey these commandments? All these laws were meant for the Israelites at that point of time only to present them differently from others and are not binding on Christians today. When Jesus died on the cross, he put an end to the Old Testament laws, as in Romans 10:4, which says, for Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. Also Galatians 3:23-25 and Galatians 6:2 confirm that faith in Christ's new covenant replaces the Old Testament laws. And Matthew 22:37-40 reiterates that if we love God and love our neighbor, we'll be covering all the Old Testament laws. Wars mentioned in Old Testament are God's plan at that point of time. We don't have to support war now. We are asked to pray for Israel. Though Jesus lived as a Jew respecting all Jewish culture, he interpreted Old Testament laws in the right way by giving importance to saving a son or ox fallen into the well or Sabbath, as in Luke 14:5 and Luke 6:9, and allowing the disciples to pluck grains on Sabbath when they were hungry, as explained in Luke 6:1-5. And in Luke 6:5, Jesus says, the Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath. Apostle Paul took great pride in his Jewish heritage by claiming it in Philippians 3:5 as having been circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, in regard to the law, a Pharisee. The following verses prove that Paul respected Old Testament laws and culture at that point of time. In 1 Corinthians 9:20, Paul says, "To the Jews I became as a Jew in order to win Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, though not being myself under the law, that I might win those under the law." But in Galatians 3:28, Paul explains, "There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male or female, for you are all in Christ Jesus." So these examples prove Paul respected the Jewish laws and cultures of the nations he lived. My point is, we don't have to give so much importance to today's Israel misquoting Bible verses. Of course, they excel in a lot of areas. Every country excels in some area or other. We don't have to give so much importance to today's Israel. Most of the Israelites today don't believe in the whole Bible. Not all Israel government laws are biblical these days. They need Jesus Christ and salvation. Psalm 122:6 says, "Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May all who love you be secure." And Matthew 22:37-40 reiterates that if we love God and love our neighbor, we'll be covering all the Old Testament laws. Wars mentioned in Old Testament are God's plan at that point of time. We don't have to support war now.